Hello guys, sorry about that, the card was full. Yeah, the box stitch. This is not an easy stitch, which is why a lot of people don't use it. I've always loved this stitch. It's one of the first stitch that I learned to do because I knew it was kind of hard, and I thought if I can master this, it'll open up a world of projects for me. So this is my way of doing it. This is how I've always done it. One of the first few projects I ever made, it was a camera case for my old man's phone, was a box stitch. So yeah, basically you've got two pieces of leather that are, they call it a box stitch because it was used for making up leather boxes. You've got two pieces of leather that are going to be like that, butted up together. You have to go through an angle. You have to go through at an angle and come out your middle section, and then the other section will be through straight, and then you get perfectly right angled joints, which is a lot different. I mean, what I could have done with this is I could have either inverted the leather in like that and sewn from the inside, and then you'd have that kind of look, or I could have butted the two up together here, skived this down, and then sewn the two pieces together like that kind of look. I could have put the two pieces together and put a piece of piping in the middle, but then it would have looked like any other commercial bag really, with very very high standard leather. Excuse me, but by doing it this, you know, I don't hold me to the, I think there is some machines that'll do the box stitch, but normally this type of stitch is done by hand. It's a handmade, you know, normally, because, you know, to buy a machine, if there is, probably is, would be running to the thousands and thousands and thousands of pounds. That's probably one of the reasons why. Actually, I think there's I can't think, there is a box stitching machine, but to go around a bag like this anyway, normally when you see box stitched items, it's handmade really. So it's a great stitch. It gives this look that I was after with this bag. It will give it this sleek design. Okay, so I'm taking my awl, I'm finding the awl on the other side, not pushing through too much. And then what I'm doing, I'm taking my needle, you can just see it here, ah, there we go, coming through. Creating my loop, shorten it a bit, don't normally have it that short, but then I'm finding that again. What I'm doing, I'm giving it a tug, because I know, I can tell that's the needle's caught the, you wouldn't have heard that then, that it's come off, the needle had actually gone through this. Now if I'd have pulled them two together then, it would have been fine until I got near enough to the two end of the loops, and then it would have been a to in and fro in motion. And then you can either pull and break the thread, which you probably won't do with this, but if it's only just caught, you will, then you're going to have a frayed thread, and to me that's no good. You know, you're not getting the full potential out of the thread. You have to undo your needles, pull them back out and start again. That's the proper way of doing that, if you catch. But if you give that needle a little pull, I'll see if I can force it and I'll show you what I mean. Right. The art of this is getting the right, with whatever leather you're using, is getting the right distance apart from one side to the other, so that they marry when you come through with your awl. I'll see if I can get this to catch the thread, and I'll show you what I mean. Right, now, when I pull the thread, there we go, I'll try and zoom this in now. You see how the thread's actually in the needle? I've really exaggerated that. But as I've pulled that thread, look, he's pulling that needle out, and that thread is actually caught in that needle. Now, if I'd have carried on going there, and when I pulled that out, that would have transferred to the other side, and you wouldn't be able to pull the two together, and you wouldn't get your proper stitch. So this is, it's not just this stitch you have to be careful of with this, it's all saddle stitching. So if you pull that off the needle, make sure it's going back through the loop. Give it a little pull. Make sure them two loops are equal. Nice even pressure, so all the stitches are the same. And we'll go again. As you can see, you know, this is a very time consuming stitch. It's probably one of the hardest to master, and to, well, not just to master, but to get right and getting, so it's aesthetically pleasing as well. I mean, you know, you could just ram the needle through either, you're all through, there we go again, through either side, and you'll have all higgledy piggledy stitching, or one side will be too over here and one side will be too short. To get this stitch right and looking nice, I suppose is where the skill comes in, and the practice. We'll go again. I'll re-burnish all this edge as well when this is when we've pulled all this together. Next step then is the handles. Give it a little pull. This time it's not caught. Also, it probably will happen on the way along. What happens is eventually, is as you're coming down to the corner down there, you'll have to start backtracking on your stitching to even your stitch out. When it comes to that, I'll film again and I'll show you what I mean, how to sort that out. And that works with your normal stitch as well. If you're going round bends, this is something you'll have to learn how to do if you're going round tight bends. Otherwise, you'll be trying to come through the holes at a severe angle to catch up. I'll show you what I mean. It's sometimes with this leather work, it's really hard to explain. It's just better to show you. So I'm going to carry on with this for an extra bit, and when I come to the corner, or I start getting to that kind of point, I'll just turn this round to show you what it looks like from the outside. There we go. Then you have two beautiful stitches, one side and the other side of an equal spacing, and what you have then is a perfect right angle. Which is real different. It's not normally what you'll see on bags. So that was the other reason why I wanted to do it. Looks a bit different here until you actually see. Okay, I forgot to press record. Oh dear, it might happen again, but I doubt it now. Anyway, I'll just try and explain it. To sort out, right, I was going through like this because I'd come round the bend. She's just out of shot here, and you end up, as you come round the bend, it pushes your stitches out, so you're at a real severe angle, like this with your needle. How can I show you this now? Oh, I can't really. If it happens again, I'll try and press record. Show you a few more stitches of me. Going through this is going to look as always, I suppose. There we go. I'm glad I've got a fight with one here, just to show you. It's not always. You'll have to come back through with your awl. Find your channel again. You should be able to slip it through then. Pull on that. See how it's stuck in the needle again? Take that out. Back through. Pull. As always, it'll probably look easy with me doing this, but as always, make sure you know, do it on a bit of scrap. Don't build up a complete project and then decide to want to do it. When you're coming through with the awl, guys, you don't want to be pushing too hard, because you'll mess this stitch up. It's important to, you know, have a nice even pull to try and keep your stitch line straight. If you pull really hard on one and loose on another, you'll tend to find it'll waver a little bit. I mean, a little bit's okay, but you know, try and minimise it as much as possible. You know, try and have consistent when you pull each thread, try and give the same amount of pressure on each side. You'll find that your stitch will lay a lot better, in whether you're doing this stitch or any stitch really. Oh yeah, bugger. It's in the thread. There we go. Okay, guys, right, it's recording this time. Now, it has happened, so. Right, you see how much of an angle? I don't know whether you can see that. To you, I know it might not look so, might look a bit more exaggerated with the awl. Right, there you go. Now, what I want basically is the awl to be coming through that way, nice and straight. It makes my life a lot easier. It saves me fighting with the awl this way, to, you know, and eventually it will get less and less until I'll be going through at that angle, and it will just start tearing and causing a right mess. To sort this out, what you have to do is you have to go back through a stitch. Now, this is where I'm at. So what we're going to do to sort this out is we're going to come back through one stitch there like that, right, with just one thread, one side. I'll show you. Right, come back through. You will never be able to see this is happened. It will just look normal. Then I've gone back through one, sorry, and I've come back with the other stitch. We'll go back through that And this works for both if you're going around with a normal saddle stitch as well as the box stitch or any stitch. If you find that your stitches are going off, right, we're back to opposite and opposite now, perpendicular as normal. What you'll find now, look, is I could just go through straight again. And it's corrected that slant. And that comes from going round bends, going round corners. As you go round a corner, the holes won't be perfectly lined and you'll have to backtrack a couple of, sometimes you have to go back two, sometimes three, sometimes one to correct it. It all depends on how severe the angle is you're going round and how much it kicked it out. Hope this makes sense, guys. So if you're doing a project where you find that you're fighting for the holes and they're at an angle, if you back up a couple like that until they level out and you can start going back through with the all straight again, that, see how, you know, I'm away again now, instead of fighting with it at an angle, it's just straight through, what, and I'm away again. Whereas if I hadn't have done that, I'd be coming through the stitch holes at such an angle, and you know, and then you're trying to come round and catch that hole, it'll put all the stitches out, you know, and it'll just be a nightmare. So anyway, guys, I got there. Okay, thought I'll press the record this time. Okay, guys, take care for now. Lee.